بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا وحبيبنا ومصطفانا محمد رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اهتدى بهداه علمنا اللهم ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم وتب علينا يا مولانا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم واغفر لنا ذنوبنا أجمعين إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير. Today is the 27th of March, 2020. Could be the 3rd or the 2nd of Sha'ban, 1441 Hijri. It is a Friday, and right now is the time of Al-Khutbah regularly. But since we cannot give Al-Khutbah, Khutbah Friday, in the Masajid, and nothing, by the way, can replace Al-Khutbah in the Masjid. And what we are given right now, me and maybe other imams also in this city and in the whole world, only to have kind of awad, yani to kind of replacement and to encourage or to enrich our soul and our nafs in this on this great day, Yawm al-Jumu'ah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in Surah Al-Anbiya, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةِ وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. The translation of the meaning of this ayah, everyone is going to taste death, and we shall make a trial of you with evil and with good, and to us you will be returned. وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will test us with good and with bad, with good and with evil, to know who will be patient and accept Allah's decree. And Allah reminded us in this verse, وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And you shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you read Al-Quran al-Kareem, you find many ayat in Al-Quran al-Kareem ended by قوله تعالى إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Many verses in Al-Quran al-Kareem ended by the following: verily, in this is indeed an evident proof and a manifest sign for people who give thought, for people who think deeply. Verily, in these signs, in this plague, in this contagious disease, what's so-called corona, there are many signs, many ayat, many lessons, many proofs, many evidence, many signs for people who reflect. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make all of us among them. And there are some ayat also ended by قوله تعالى لعلهم يتذكرون. Perhaps, or they might remember or receive admonition. In Surah Al-Qasas, only in Surah Al-Qasas itself, there are three ayat ended لعلهم يتذكرون. Ayah number 43, and ayah number 46, and ayah number 41. And we'll pick one of these ayat, ayah number 42, 43. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَقَدْ أَتَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا أَهْلَكْنَا الْقُرُونَ الْأُولَى بَصَائِرَ لِلنَّاسِ وَهُدًا وَرَحْمَةً لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ. And indeed, we gave Musa alayhi salam after we had destroyed the generations of old, in generations before the time of Musa alayhi salam, we gave him the scripture, which is a Torah, as enlightenment for mankind and as a guidance and a mercy that they might remember and receive admonition. Also, there are some ayat ended by قوله تعالى لعلهم يذكرون. ويذكرون مثل يتذكرون is almost the same. Among these ayat, One ayah in Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, وَلَقَدْ أَخَذْنَا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ بِالسِّنِينَ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَذَّكَّرُونَ. And listen to the translation of this ayah, to the meaning of this ayah. And indeed, we punished the people of Fir'aun, Pharaoh, with years of drought and shortness of fruit, crops, food, provisions, that they might remember, they might take heed. Also in Surah At-Tawbah, there is a great, great ayah. Indeed, we should نتفكر فيها, to think deeply about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about some people. And if you look at the ayat before and after this ayah, ayah 126 from Surah Tawbah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talk about al-munafiqeen wa al-azhu billah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَوَلَا يَرَوْنَا أَنَّهُمْ يُفْتَنُونَ فِي كُلِّ عَامٍ مَرَّةً أَوْ مَرَّتَيْنِ ثُمَّ لَا يَتُوبُونَ وَلَا هُمْ يَذَّكَّرُونَ وَلَا يَذُو بِاللَّهِ. The translation of this ayah, see, they not that they are tried once or twice every year with different kinds of calamities, diseases, famines, etc. Yet they turn not in repentance, nor do they learn a lesson from it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in this ayah, and there is no doubt there is wisdom behind all Allah's decree, all Allah's decision, and all Allah's wills, there are wisdom behind it. Here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a tradition, a sunnah, sunnatullah, التي لن تجد لسنة الله تبديلا ولن تجد لسنة الله تحويلا. That Allah subhanahu, among his sunan, among his traditions with people, that sometime Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tried the people and test the people once or twice, a huge test and a huge tried a year. Only for two reasons. ثُمَّ لَا يَتُوبُونَ وَلَهُمْ يَذَّكَّرُونَ. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did this to the people. Perhaps they return to Allah in repentance or to think deeply about it and to stop all the wrong things and bad deeds that they are committing. So we have to have, brothers and sisters in Islam, a big lesson from this pandemic diseases. We have to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with sincerity. We have to pause the time if we can, for sure we cannot, but we can take time out and think and reflect and receive admonition. Brothers and sisters in Islam, among things that we have to think and to have a lesson, that al-Muslim, the Muslim and the Muslima remember all the time and believes that al-khayr wa shar is biqadr Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the good and the bad and the evil and the benefit is by Allah's decree without any doubt. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, inna kulla shay'in khalaqnahu biqadr wama amruna illa wahidatun كَلَمْحٍ بِالْبَصَرِ مِثْلَ رَفَّةِ الْعَيْنِ هَكَذَا أَمْرُ اللَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Verily, we created all things, everything, the good and the bad. Anything can befall the man, can befall the person, is by Allah's decree, by divine decrees. And our commandment is but one. And this one is by the word kun. Anything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to be, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants anything to be, just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kun, that means be, and it will be. And our commandment is but one, as the twinkling of an eye. And nothing in this universe can happen without Allah's knowledge or Allah's command. And there is a deep wisdom, hikmah, in Allah's decree. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tests his servants and with good and with bad, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-A'raf, وَبَلَوْنَاهُمْ بِالْحَسَنَاتِ وَالسَّيِّئَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْجِعُونَ. And we tried them with good, with blessings, and with evil, calamities, and this plague and this contagious disease, corona, is one of these calamities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we tried them with good and with bad in order that they might turn to Allah's obedience. They obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and follow the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stay far away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade. Also, brothers and sisters in Islam, al-Muslim and al-Muslima remembers and takes a lesson that all these calamities happened because people, they crossed the lines and they committed lots of haram. And they went far away in doing haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Ash-Shura, and listen to this ayah, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ وَيَعْفُو عَنْ كَثِيرٍ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. Let us reflect this ayah and think deeply about this ayah and take a lesson from this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and whatever of misfortune befalls you, it is because of what your hands have earned and committed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardons much. Allah will forgive a lot. But what happened to us as calamities, plagues, because of what the people committed. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Fatir, وَلَوْ يُؤَاخِذُ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِمَا كَسَبُوا ما ترك على ظهرها من دابة لا إله إلا الله ولكن يؤخرهم إلى أجل مسمى وهذا رحمة من الله فإذا جاء أجلهم فإن الله كان بعباده بصيرا سبحانه وتعالى. The translation of this, the meaning of this ayah, and if Allah were to punish men, to punish people for that which they earned, what they committed as haram in this, on this earth, he would not leave a moving, a living creature on the surface of the earth. That means Allah, if you want to punish people because what they committed as haram, he would kill and destroy everybody on the surface of the earth. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them respite to an appointed term. And when their term comes, then verily Allah is ever all seer of his slaves. In Surah An-Nahl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَوْ يُؤَخِذُ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِظُلْمِهِمْ مَا تَرَكَ عَلَى ظَهْرِهَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ ولكن يؤخرهم إلى أجل مسمى فإذا جاء أجلهم لا يستأخرون ساعة ولا يستقدمون. In Surah An-Nahl, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if Allah were to punish mankind for their wrongdoing, here al-ayah said for their ظلم وليعوذ بالله, he would not leave on it, on the earth, a single moving, living creature. But he postpones then for an appointed term. And when their term comes, neither can they delay, not can they advance it an hour or even a moment. That ayah shows the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we know one authentic hadith narrated in Sunan Ibn Majah and Al-Albani rahimahullah, rated as sahih, sound. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لم تظهر الفاحشة في قوم قط يعني دون استثناء حتى يعلنوا بها هذا الشرط الثاني إلا فشى فيهم الطاعون والأوجاع التي لم تكن في أسلافهم الذين مضوا. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام told us one of Allah's tradition, Allah's Sunan, that when any generation or any people in any country, if they start to commit the major sins, especially al-fahisha, which is the sins of adultery, then he said, وَيُعْلِنُوا بِهَا. Not only it's spread all around, not only the majority of the people are committing this kind of fahisha, of haram. No, they announce it and they consider it as normal. I think nothing happened, or marriage or adultery. And today we can say the same marriage sex as if that's normal, when they consider it as normal. Plus, when they make it as a law, not only it's spread all around, no, as a law. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we believe Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We trusted Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whatever Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in authentic hadith, we believe it as is. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam here told us one of Allah's tradition, one of Allah's decision, that if such kind of wrong doing, such kind of haram, of a major sins, spread all around the community, and they start to make it normal and make it as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send to them a ta'un. Here I don't want to discuss the medical terminology now, which ta'un, because of virus or bacteria, I don't want to go through this. But a ta'un, we can say like a plague, contagious disease, as corona today. And al-awja' means al-amrad, not pain, a painful disease or painful illness. So a ta'un, the plague, and the painful disease will spread all around. They spread all around al-haram, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish them and spread all around this kind of plagues and contagious disease. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the previous ayah, فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punish you with this because of what your hand committed, because what people did. What kind of disease? أَلَّتِي لَمْ تَكُنْ فِي أَسْلَافِهِمُ الَّذِينَ مَضَوْا. And a new disease, a new illness, a new viruses, a new contagious disease. It wasn't known with previous generations. This is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned, not only Muslims, warned the humanity, warned all mankind with this. And our role is to tell, to spread, and to deliver this message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the message of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because Muslims, wherever he lives, wherever he is haris ala nashr al khair, all the time, yani deliver the good message, and wants, the Muslim wants the goodness and the good for all the humanity. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take this hardship and these calamities and this plague from all people soon. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us and all people to return back to Him and to stop doing the bad deed, especially the major bad deed. إنه على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.